Good morning, students. We are going to start with the chapter of rotation and revolution. We have already seen the basics of how the earth rotates and the time it takes, and also the basics of revolution. So in this video, we are going to focus on how the earth's rotation and revolution affect various, what are the impacts they have. Now, the first effect of the Earth's rotation, we know that it spins around itself and it takes 24 hours to rotate around itself. Now, when this is happening, what happens is that there is literally a line that is created. Now, we know that the part that faces the Earth the Sun experiences daytime, and the part which is away from the Sun is dark and experiences night. Now, as the Earth is tilted at a certain angle, a part of the Earth comes under a shadow. Now, this shadow actually creates a line that separates day from the night. Now, this line of shadow which is caused is called as the line of illumination. So, what is the line of illumination? It is a shadow that falls in such a way that there is a line that seems to separate day from the night. Now, since the Earth rotates in an anti-clockwise direction, we feel like the Sun is rising in the east and sets in the west. And that is how we measure the length of day and night. Now, what we're going to look at right now are the different parts of the day that we experience, starting with noon. What happens at noon? The Sun is directly overhead, right above our heads, and it causes a perpendicular angle. So it creates a 90 degree angle. And when this happens, we say that we experience noon, that is midday or 12 in the afternoon. Now, what happens after this? The Earth starts, Sun starts setting, and it causes slanted rays. And after a few years, we are going to be near at evening. And what happens in the evening? Just as the last rays of the Sun are fading away below the horizon, we have the dusk. The time of the day is called as dusk. What is dusk? Dusk is that period when just before the Sun sets at the horizon, that the Sun's rays are slowly fading away. So it's not completely dark, but it's not bright either. So that part of the day is called as the dusk. And when the Sun sets below the horizon, what is that time called? The night. Now, as the Sun starts rising again, just before the Sun rises and comes above the horizon, we experience the period of the day called the dawn. So what is dawn? Dawn is the time of the day when the first rays of the Sun are just coming out of the horizon. So that is the dawn. And then we have the daytime when the Sun is nice shining bright in the sky. So what are the different times of the day that we experience because of the Earth's rotation? We will start with noon, which is the Sun's rays directly overhead, and that is at 12 o'clock. Then it slowly starts shifting, and the slanted rays of the Sun Sun's rays start slanting, and it causes the evening. And just before the Sun is about to set, we have the phenomena called the dusk. That is the part of the day when the Sun's rays are slowly fading away from the horizon, and that part of the day is called as the dusk. And once the Sun sets, it's called night. And just again in the morning, before the Sun starts coming out of the horizon, we have the rays are slowly coming out of the horizon. So that is the period of the day which is called the dawn. So that is again an effect of the Earth's rotation. Now, another effect of the Earth's rotation is that we have different periods of day and night. It is not the same. Days and nights are not equal hours. Why? That is because of the tilt of the axis. Now, how do we know that the axis tilted? Axis is tilted. If you place your fist with your thumbs raised, what happens? It causes a perpendicular angle. And when this perpendicular angle is created, you know that it is straight. But is the axis of the Earth straight? No, it is tilted. So when you just tilt your thumb, you will get that angle. So the Earth's axis is tilted at a degree of 23.5. And we need to remember this. So it does not cause a 90 degree angle. It causes a tilt, and it is tilted at a 23.5 degree angle, and this is why we have different lengths of day and night. Only at the equator they experience equal day and equal night. That is because the sun's rays are directly shining at the equator. Now the earth's rotation has also affected the shape of the earth. So the earth is geoid shape, that is bulging at the equator and flattened at the poles. And why is this happening? This happens because the earth is spinning faster at the equator, and it causes the earth to spread more at the equator, and so the earth's shape is known as the geoid shape. So next time somebody asks you what is the shape of the earth, please answer it is geoid. Why does this happen? Because the earth's spinning movement is faster at the equator, and because of this faster motion the earth spreads out more at the equator. Now apart from this, there is also the part of the day, part of the poles that experience 24 hours of daylight in the middle of summer. This happens at the poles, and Norway is called the land of the midnight sun. Why does this happen? This is because the sun never sets in this region between the months of late May and late July. These are their summer months. Alright, and why does this happen? Because the earth's axis is tilted towards the North Pole is tilted towards the sun, and it takes that much time for it to move away from the sun. So it experiences, the poles experience 24 hours of day in the summer, in the middle of the summer, and they experience 24 hours of night in the middle of winter. So this is how the earth's rotation affects how we experience day and night. Now what does a revolution do? We know that revolution causes seasons, and we have learnt the different seasons. You all can refer to the previous video links that I have shared in the description box so that you can revise the topic again. So today what are we going to focus on? We've already learnt that it takes 6 months for the earth to shift from its position to come to the opposite side, and that is how the seasons are caused. We have also learnt about the solstices and the equinoxes. So in this image I have put up the different seasons that are there in the southern hemisphere and in the winter season. So then if you, for example, just look at the image at December 21, 22, what do we see there? The North Pole is away from the sun and the South Pole is closer towards the sun. Which part of the diagram am I looking at? At the one at the position of the earth on December 21, 22. So what happens because of that? Since the South Pole is closer to the sun, it is going to experience summer season. But the northern hemisphere is away from the sun, and so they're going to experience winter season. So the same thing, the exact opposite is going to happen 6 months later. Look at the image at June 2021. Now what has happened in this position? The earth's north pole is closer to the sun and the south pole is away from the sun. So the exact opposite season is going to be experienced in the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. So now in June, towards the June, it is the summer season at the northern hemisphere, at the North Pole, and at the southern hemisphere and at the South Pole they're going to experience winter season. So that is how the seasons are affected or caused because of the revolution of the earth. Now what does solstice mean? Solstice means that the sun is directly overhead. What is this overhead sun? Overhead is when the sun's rays fall perpendicularly on the earth's surface. So whenever, now in this image what can you see? You can see that the sun's rays are exactly perpendicular at the equator. Now when the sun is overhead between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn and crosses the equator twice a year. Now as the earth still shifts from the northern hemisphere to the southern hemisphere, there are going to be, the overhead sun is going to be at different places in because of the revolution of the earth. And that is what we're going to look at the solstices. During the course of this movement, solstices and equinoxes occur. Sorry. So what is this solstice? The term solstice actually means, it comes from the Latin words sol, which means sun, and sistis means to stand still. So sun is sol, and sistis means to stand still. So literally it means that the sun is standing still. This is an image of what happens on June 21st in the northern hemisphere. How do you know it is in the northern hemisphere? Because the Earth's axis, the North Pole, is facing towards the sun, and the South Pole is away from the sun and is in the shadow. So that is how we know that this is in the northern hemisphere. So what happens on June 21st in the northern hemisphere? I've highlighted it. The sun's rays are directly the overhead on the Tropic of Cancer in the northern hemisphere. And what happens on this day? It is the longest day of the year. On this day, the sun is directly overhead of the Tropic of Cancer. Now, what is happening in the southern hemisphere at the same time? At the same time, in the southern hemisphere, they are experiencing winter solstice. So, they have the shortest day of the year in the southern hemisphere. Whereas in the northern hemisphere, we experience the longest day on June 21st because the sun is directly overhead of the Tropic of Cancer. Alright, so this is summer solstice for the northern hemisphere. Now, 6 months later, on December 22nd, the sun is overhead of the Tropic of Capricorn, again highlighted in this picture. Now, this is again in the northern hemisphere. This is with reference to the northern hemisphere. What happens now? On December 22nd, the sun is overhead at the Tropic of Capricorn. Northern hemisphere going to experience? Northern hemisphere is going to experience winter solstice, whereas the southern hemisphere is going to experience summer solstice. Why? Because northern hemisphere is now away from the sun, and so they're going to experience winter. So on December 22nd, the northern hemisphere is going to experience winter solstice, and the southern hemisphere is going to experience summer solstice. So you have to understand that this is what is happening differently in the northern hemisphere and in the southern hemisphere. So when northern hemisphere is experiencing summer solstice, southern hemisphere experiences winter solstice. When southern hemisphere is experiencing summer solstice, northern hemisphere experiences winter solstice. So the exact opposite is happening in the northern and the southern hemisphere. What happens during the equinoxes? What is this equinox? Equinox is also again from the Latin words. Two words they have come from: equis, which means equal, and nox, which means night. So what does that mean? It means that we have equal length of day and night. And what happens on an equinox is that the sun is directly overhead at the equator, and so we have equal days and nights all over the earth. Now, the equinoxes occur twice a year, generally around March 20 and September 22nd. Now, in spring or vernal equinox, what happens is that is during March 20th in the northern hemisphere, it begins the spring season. On this day, what happens? The sun's rays fall directly on the equator, and there is equal day and night all over the world. The spring season is followed by the summer. Now, at the same time, what is going to happen at the southern hemisphere? Southern hemisphere experiences autumn equinox, which is followed by the winter season. Autumn equinox occurs around September 22nd in the northern hemisphere, which is followed by the winter season. During the same period, southern hemisphere is going to experience spring equinox. So exactly opposite of what happened in the solstices. So the exact same thing is over here. Equinox, if it is experiencing, northern hemisphere experiences one equinox, the other is going to reverse, is going to experience at the southern hemisphere. I'm going to stop here. This is the end of the chapter. Go through the video again. Refer to the older videos again so that you have your concepts clear and you understand how the equinoxes occur. And we have to practice all the diagrams so that you know when the sun is overhead and which seasons are caused because of those positions of the sun. I'll stop here. Have a nice day.